This conference will now be recorded.
Srinivas?
Yeah, hi Murthy.
Was Jamal joined for today?
Yeah, he told me he's joining actually.
Yeah, Nicholas joined and Jamal?
Yeah, Jamal has to join actually. I'm waiting for Jamal.
Oh, okay, no problem. So today, can you hear Nicholas today? Nicholas?
Yes. Is able to
yes,
speak.
Yes, hi, hi, Morali, hi. Yeah, today I joined the class from my telephone. You can hear me. Yeah.
Oh, that's great then. Yeah. So you continue with the session, Srinivas. No problem. So anyway, we are recording the call, right? You know, even if you join 5-10 minutes late, then you know, so we'll share it. No problem. Okay.
Okay. I will start now. Okay. So, Nicholas, I'm starting the class. Okay. Yesterday, we discussed on the discrete manufacturing. In that, the one of the processes make to stock. Yesterday, I explained the what is a process, means where we will start from the forecast, MRP run, and then we will get the after MRP, we will get the planned orders. We will convert that into production orders and release the production order. Then we will, after production, physical production, we will do the confirmation and goods movements. This is the end-to-end process in make to stock. In this process, do you have any questions? Is it clear?
No, I don't have. No. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay. So this is like your end-to-end process. Like in MMD, you will get the purchase requisition, you will convert to purchase order and goods movements, everything. Okay. Like that, in PP also, you will have this process, end-to-end process, where it is a make-to-stock production. Now, to make this process in SAP, we need master data also. We need, for any module, we required some master data. So PP also, you required master data. The master data in PP is, any idea? What are the master data in PP?
I'm sorry.
Yeah. What is the master data in PP?
It is article. Idea? Yeah, article. Okay. Maybe, and sometimes you have a bomb. Maybe you do bomb and article component. Article material does mean, and
yeah.
Sometimes you do material and bomb. Maybe you do bomb.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe I don't know if you have. Any, should we do info record processing for record or not necessary?
Yeah. Purchase info record is for a purchasing purpose only, but we don't require here.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, you don't. Yeah.
Okay. So in master data, first we need a material master. Then we need a bill of material. Bill of material is nothing but what are the materials you required to manufacture a product. Then we need work center. Work center means the machine or place where we will do the manufacturing. Where we will do the manufacturing. That is called the work center. And another master is the routing. Routing is nothing but a route, nothing but what are the steps you will follow to manufacture that product. What are the steps? Like, first you will assemble the engine, second you will assemble the tires, next you will assemble the glasses. So those are the steps it involves in manufacturing a car. So those steps we will maintain in routing master data. So another master data is production version. This is nothing but a combination of BOM plus routing. This is nothing but a combination of bill of material and routing. So these are the main master data we will use in PP module. So apart from this, for our practice purpose, we require to create info record also, purchase info record. So these are the master data mainly we will use in our session. Okay. So first we will discuss on the material master. So in material master, we will discuss what are the fields required in this material master creation. I think you are already working on S/4HANA. So you know the how is the Fury and how is the logon pad?
Yes.
So there is, yeah. Okay. So we will go with the GUI. And I will explain the important fields in this material master. So path for this one is logistics. You will find the production here, and in that master data, then material master. It is still opening. Material, then create general MM01. This is the transaction code we generally use to create a product. So I am creating a product like Honda car, and industry is M, and I am creating this as a FERT material, like finished product. And with respect to PP, you can see in the material master, you will have the different views. These views are respect to different modules. So here, respect to example like purchasing. So you will select mainly the purchasing and international trade and purchase order. And if you want to work on the SD, these are the views for SD. Like that, specific to PP, production is MRP 1, 2, 3, 4, and work scheduling. These are the five views which are specific to PP module. So apart from this, I am selecting the basic data, one, and accounting. Costing and accounting views. But for PP prospectus, the main views are MRP 1, 2, 3, 4 and work scheduling. So I am creating this in 1000 plant in 0001. Oh, 1000. Doesn't know. I am trying to create, but some plants are not good. Data is not maintained properly. Okay, so I'm entering the description. Honda City car, and this is each. So here are the important fields in MRP. The first field is MRP type. This MRP type will control the planning of a product. Planning of a product in MRP run. We will have a different types of MRP types. So in S4, actually some of the MRP types they are removed. But these are the main MRP types in S4. Different types like MPS, you have forecast, time phased planning, and normal MRP, and then reorder point planning, forecast based planning. But I will explain you all these MRP types after 2-3 classes, each MRP type. These are the different MRP types we will use in planning purpose based on the how customer wants to do the planning. So at present I am selecting the PD. This is a general MRP type we will use for planning. And here one more field is their MRP group. You can group certain settings related to this product using MRP group. In MRP group also you can do the some settings which are related to MRP. And here another field is there, plant specific material status. This means if you want to block this material after a certain time, you want to block this material in this plant, then you can use the statuses here. Example like absolute. So it will get blocked. No one can use this material. Or you can use the different status of this material to control this usage of this material. That too, this is specific to a plant. And next is MRP controller. MRP controller is only a person who do the MRP related things. And this controller you can use for a reporting purpose also. That means in a company, example, for production purpose, you have 3 people are there. Who is taking care of FG material? The person who is taking care of SFG and some raw materials. Three people are there. So you can give those people name with respect to these products. So, and this field you can use for reporting purpose also, which are the materials I am responsible for planning. You can put your MRP controller, your name. So in this system there is no controller, so I am creating one controller here. You can click on new entries, you can enter the plant and any name here, example like A1, FG planning planner. That means he will do the FG materials planning. Next is important field is lot size. Do you have any idea on this lot size?
Yes, exact lot, fixed lot, dynamic lot, and one-to-one lot. It's, you know, I have a good idea. I don't know if this is still the same, the standard I work on like 20 years ago, in 1999. Okay, it was standard MRP. I think it is the same, is that right?
Yes.
Exact lot, fixed lot. There is a dynamic and something else.
Yeah, exactly. That is same only. Concept is same. Okay. There is no change. FX is fixed lot. Lot for lot order quantity X. And daily lot size, period based lot sizes. Okay. The lot size, nothing but how much group of quantity you want to produce. Okay, lot for lot order quantity, fixed order quantity, monthly lot size, daily lot size, weekly lot size. These are the different lot sizes we have. Okay, and as per this lot size setting, you can do the other settings like fixed lot size, minimum lot size, maximum lot size. These values you can fill it up. Okay, and here one more important thing is there, assembly scrap. What is scrap means?
Are you talking about the scrap material? Scrap does mean,
yeah,
what you, yeah,
scrap means it is a wastage. Okay, scrap means it is a wastage which is coming out from the production. While doing the production, you will get some wastage that is called nothing but a scrap. In manufacturing, we will have three types of scraps. One is assembly scrap. Second one is component scrap. Third one is operational scrap. These are the three kinds of scraps. And these scraps we will maintain in master data as a percentage. It is always a percentage. Maybe a 5%, 10% or 1%. So in this, what is assembly scrap? Assembly scrap means assembly, means it is a product. After making the product, it is got rejected during the quality test. Then that is called the assembly scrap. Example, you manufacture a bulb. After manufacturing of a bulb, it is not glowing. So it is completely assembled the bulb. After that, it is not glowing. No light is coming from that bulb. So then it is a assembly scrap. It is got scrapped after manufacturing. That is called the assembly scrap. Component scrap. Component scrap means while manufacturing a product, one of the component got wasted. It is not good. That is called the component scrap. Example, like while assembling the car, you will use the bolts and nuts. So one of the bolt is not good. So that is a scrap. That is component itself, item itself is damaged while assembling the car. So that is called the component scrap. And third is operational scrap. Operational scrap means in one of the operation, so that operation got scrapped. Operation means assembling or making a product. That time, that means in between of the product, it is not a complete product, it is not a component. During that time, it is got failed. So then that wastage is called operational scrap. So these scraps we will maintain in different master data. Like assembly scrap, you will maintain in material master. Component scrap also we will maintain in the material master. Operational scrap we will maintain in bill of material. These are the different areas we will maintain these scrap values. Any questions on the scrap?
No.
Is it clear? Is it clear concept?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay. So as per this scrap, whatever you maintain here, system increase your demand. Okay. During the MRP planning. For example, you maintain the scrap as 10%. So in you need to produce, you need a requirement of 100 quantity. You need to produce 100 cars. So as you maintain 10% scrap, then after MRP, system will create a planned order with a quantity of 110 each. Because you maintain 10%, it will go as a scrap. So you need 100 quantity of good product. You need to make 110 products. Then out of that 10% will go as a scrap. Finally, you will have a good product of 100 quantity. So this calculation will happen during the MRP. So that is the importance of this scrap. So these are the important fields in MRP1. So next, in MRP2, important field is procurement. So in procurement is nothing but how you are getting this product. So in SAP you have a three types of procurement types: E, F and X. E means which are the materials you want to manufacture in your plant. Those are called in-house procurement or in-house production. That means E means which are the products you are making in your plant. And F means which are the products you are purchasing from vendor, from outside. Those are called F. External procurement. And sometimes, because of certain reasons, some products you will manufacture and at the same time you will purchase also the same product. As semi-finished product, you will manufacture and sometimes it is required to purchase from outside also because of your capacity constraint or you don't have the sufficient manufacturing facility. So that time you will manufacture and you will purchase the product. So those products you need to maintain the procurement type as this one. This is called the both. It is a combination of in-house and external. So this is the setting we will maintain. This is one of the important setting. So you can see E, in-house production, F, external procurement, and X is both procurement types. So I am creating the FG Material Honda car. So it is, we will produce in-house. So I am selecting the procurement type as E. And as you know, you are the MM person. We will have the other scenarios procuring the material. In procuring the material, we have a different scenarios. Like you are getting the material from another plant. Sometimes you are getting from the vendor, consignment, subcontracting. These are the different processes in MM. So those processes, if you want to use, so those are nothing but a special procurement. You will maintain this special procurement also for the different kind of materials like consignment, external procurement, subcontracting, stock transfer, phantom assembly. These are the different special procurements. Each one is a one separate scenario. But PP manufacturing, you will get the stock transfer. Stock transfer means one of the component is manufacturing in a different plant. Like example, your tire is manufacturing in a different plant. So you want to procure, you want to transfer that tire from another plant. So that material you will maintain as a 40-year special procurement. So system automatically creates a stock transfer request during MRP run.
Yeah, so yes, here in the PP, we'll use only 40. This what you mean? Or we can do 100% 40-40-40 stock transfer. Is that right?
Yeah. Generally, mainly for PP prospectus, we will use 40 and 50. There is a concept. Phantom assembly is also there. 40, 50, and 52.
Okay.
40, 45, 50, 52. These are mainly for the PP. And 10, 20, 30, these are mainly for MM, specific to MM. Okay.
Yeah.
The remaining is related to, you can say, phantom production. All these are related to PP.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. But first 3, 10, 20, 30 is specific to MM. Okay. MM means it is a procurement related, consignment stock, external procurement, and subcontracting. These are specific to MM. So if you want, I will in detail explain you the remaining things after one flow is completed. One scenario is completed, then I can explain you how it works. What is phantom assembly, stock transfer, direct production, what is this? I can explain you later. Okay. But this is one of the important field in MRP. So the next is, you have a production storage location. So we can maintain this default storage location. It is just like your purchase storage location, external procurement storage location. So that means by default, whenever we do the goods receipt for this product, automatically it will get stored into this storage location. That is called production storage location. And for external procured materials, we will use the storage location for EP, externally procured materials. Okay, in this, another field is in-house production. In-house production means to assemble this product, how many days you need. That is called the in-house production days. For example, to assemble this Honda car, you need 2 days. So you will maintain that number of days here. You will maintain number of days. This is 2 days it requires to manufacture this product. If this material is a raw material, then you will maintain this planned delivery time. Planned delivery time means how many days you require to deliver that product from vendor to your location. And you have another field, GR processing time. GR processing time means goods receipt processing. Sometimes when you receive the material, immediately you won't do the goods receipt. You need to do some testing, or you need to do some sample collection. So those things will be there. So if you want certain time to do this goods receipt, you can maintain that time in goods receipt processing time. And we have a schedule margin key. Schedule margin key. In short form, this is called SMK. What is this schedule margin key means? It contains actually the four parameters inside of this key. Like these are the four parameters: OPPD, FL, AFT, PRD, and these are the four. So what is this? I will tell you. OPPD means opening period. Second is float before production. Next is float after production. Third is release period. Last one is, fourth one is a release period. All these are nothing but a certain lead times. Lead times means gap between one activity to another activity. All these are measured in days only. Unit of measure is days. So that means while doing the production, you want to certain time before starting of production or after start after completion of the production, you need a certain time. So those timings you can maintain here as a number of days. For example, opening period. Opening period means before starting of production, certain days you may required to keep your raw materials ready or to make this machine ready. That period is called the opening period. So if you want certain days for that, you can maintain number of days. Float before production, float after production. These are also number of days which you want to, which you want before starting of the production or after starting of the production. Like you want one day and this is one day. Release period. Release period means to release your production order to a shop floor. Before releasing a order to a shop floor, you need to verify the order. You want to verify the order and you want to check all the components are available or not. All those details. And you want certain days so that you can maintain as number of days here. So in schedule margin key, we will maintain four parameters. Those parameters are in number of days. So how this four will useful is during MRP run, during MRP planning, system will calculate what is the start date and end date. In MRP, system will calculate what is the start date and end date. So during that time, it will add all these number of days also. For example, to make one car, you need, for example, to assemble a car, you need 5 days. For example, you maintain that 5 days here. Here in in-house production, example, like not 5 days, 2 days. Okay, so 2 days is to manufacture one car. But if you maintain schedule margin key like these values, so then it will add 2 days plus 5 days. So it will take 7 days to manufacture. To complete the total manufacturing, it requires 7 days. Because you maintain a schedule margin key with these number of days. So during MRP, system will calculate like start date is April 1st. So the end date, it is a 7 days, means it is a 7th of April. System will calculate based on the schedule margin key. Okay. So here you can maintain the schedule margin key. For example, 000 is there and all our zeros are there. So that means you don't want to use the schedule margin key. You don't want all these periods. In another example, if you maintain this key, it is a 10 days for opening period, 1 day for float before production, after production, 2 days for before production, and release period is 5 days. So we have a total 10 plus 1 plus 2 plus 5, 18 days is your lead time. Okay, if you maintain this key, system will take 18 days as lead time, and as per this lead time, system will generate your start date and end date. Any questions till now?
No, no, thanks. Perfect.
Okay. Okay. The next important field is safety stock. Safety stock is nothing but you want to keep certain stock as a safety purpose. So how much stock quantity you want to keep, that you can maintain the value here. For example, if you maintain 10 here and system will not consider the 10 quantity for usage into next step or for delivery. So you can keep always certain stock as safety, and that stock how much you want, you can maintain it here. So if you maintain a safety stock here, the 10 quantity, it will always remain in the storage location. System won't allow you to issue that stock to another location or to a customer. So these are the important fields. We have the other fields also, like planning calendar, and those I will explain you later. So next is MRP3. So in MRP3, main important field is strategy. This strategy group will control which kind of business process you are following. You are following for this product, and this controls. This is actually the strategy group is having the integration between PP and SD. PP and SD have the integration for this strategy group. So first thing is, so the how the material is manufactured. Is it a make to stock or a make to order, or it is a both combination? That how the system knows is, it will come from this strategy group. You can see make to stock, make to order, whether you are doing by production by lots or planning with assembly. So these are the different kinds of business processes, and this material belongs to which kind of business process, that we will represent here in strategy group. And another thing is, from SD's prospectus, do you want to carry the availability check? Do you want to consume the stock from storage location? And you have the concept like requirement class and requirement type. Those details are available inside of this strategy group. Inside of this strategy group. For example, you want to check . So these are the important strategy groups. Like generally for make to stock production, generally we will use 10. If it is a make to order, 20. If it is a combination of these two, then we will use the 40. So as per this, each strategy group, your material behavior will change. Your product behavior will change. What is the configuration behind this one is, you can go here, create, and you can go here. You can select any one of this one. Inside of this, you will have the settings which are related to both. Both means production and sales. For example, I am taking this, you can see. requirement type for independent requirements. Independent requirement means it is related to production. And here requirement type for customer requirements. This setting is related to SD customers. So you can see example, whether you want to do MRP planning or not, you want to do availability check or not, is it required to transfer your requirements? What is the assignment category, account assignment category? These settings are related to SD, which is controlled with requirement class. And same way, these independent requirement means forecast. If you want to create a forecast for this product, how the system should behave, like how the consumption and how the system should calculate independent requirements. So these two, so this planning strategy or strategy group is a combination of production and sales. But further details I will explain you in future classes. Like first we will use the make to stock production, then we will use the make to order production. After that I will explain you some of these strategies in detail. But these are the setting inside of your strategy group. So I'm selecting for, we have selected this scenario like make to stock. So I am selecting the strategy as 10, make to stock production for this product. Then important field is, next is availability check. Availability check means we will perform a check whether that product is available, readily available or not. While creating your sales order, you can check your product is available or not. That checking, if you want to perform, you need to maintain this field. That is for SD during sales order creation. In production, we will check in a production order for raw material availability. Like I am checking for Honda car. So it will check whether its particular engine is available or not. So tires are available or not. To assemble a car, what are the components are required? Those are stock is available or not, system will check. So to check that, we need this availability check. And this availability check is mainly two types. One is daily requirement and another thing is individual requirement. Individual requirement means each order wise system will check the stock is available or not. For example, you created a now one sales order, and against that sales order only system will check its product is available or not. That is called individual requirement, individual checking. Individual order wise system will check availability. We have another setting, daily requirement. Daily requirement means on that day, what are the orders are there? All orders together, stock is there or not, it will check. That means today you need to deliver 10 orders, 10 sales orders. 10 sales orders with the quantities. Total quantity of 10 sales orders, example 100. So system will check 100 cars are available or not. That is called the daily requirement. On a particular day, what are the say total orders are there for that, how much quantity is required, system will check whether everything is available or not. That is daily requirements. Individual means it will check individual order wise.
Okay, if we check daily requirement, there is a message to say, okay, no availability, or is there is something warning, or how it will happen, you know.
Okay.
And if you say daily requirement, you know, there is, I have to run some transaction to see, I don't know how we are, you know, maybe you can give me around an idea about the daily requirement, how we check and validate, please.
Okay. Yeah, sure. So you see, individual requirements. So generally this setting we will use for the sales order, means for example FG materials only we will use, because while creating a sales order you need to check whether that much quantity is there or not. Individual sales order wise you will check. So generally this individual requirement type 02 we will use for FG materials. Now next is daily requirement. These generally we will use for raw materials and semi-finished product. Okay, that means raw material to manufacture 100 cars you need 100 engines. Engine is a raw material, so you will check on a particular day you need 100, so that total 100 is available or not you will check. You don't require to check engines by each order wise. Okay, you have the 10 orders, each order wise you don't require to check, you need to check daily. So those materials you will use the daily requirement. That is one thing. And second thing is to do availability check, we need a separate transaction code. We have a separate transaction code to do the availability check. That is either SAP one mass transaction is there, COHV is the transaction you can perform the availability check for production related. COHV is the transaction code. Otherwise you have a separate transaction code for this one. So that is CO09. Correct to availability check. You can use this one also, COMAC. You can use COMAC or COHV. These are the using these two transaction codes, you can get the availability of that stock. So now next question is, do you want to check you whether material is available or not, you will get any messages or not. Okay, so how you will use this one is example COHV. Okay, this is very important transaction code in manufacturing in PP. So but I will show you only, but I will explain you further in later classes. For example, you want to do material availability check, you can see, you can select this option, and here in the selections you can select which are the products you want to check and in which plant you want to check. You can select here the details, and you want to check on a particular day, production of a particular day, that you can check at the bottom. You can see here in the bottom you will have a date also, like schedule start date. Schedule start date means production start date. So here example, you want to give April 1st. What are the orders are there? You want to check those orders related components are available or not. You want to check, you can use this date. And once you execute this one, this transaction code, you will get the output. Okay, in this example, we don't have the orders actually. Otherwise, so let me execute. Okay. We don't have some test data. Okay. Example, you can see these are the orders. System perform the availability check. But now, how you know whether the component is available or not? So you will get that from the status of system status. Okay, each order you will have the status, and the status in this is, it will say you different statuses. You can see material committed, that means its related component is available. You will get the another status, material shortage. So you can see the how much is the short, means its components is not available. Okay, so this is one of the transaction code where you can use its stock is available or not. Okay, and this transaction you can run in a background also. And after availability check is over, okay, for example, that raw material is required 100, but existing stock is 60 only. So 40 is the shortage. So where you can see that shortage is, like in the same transaction, you can see here list. Here you can select the components. You can execute. And here you can see this is required quantity, and you will have the committed quantity here. Let me open another field. So by comparing those two, you can say how much is available and how much is committed, means you can see what is the, how much is the shortage. So you can find using this one how much is the shortage, you can see. Okay, using this report you can find how much is the shortage. Is it answer your question?
Yes, exactly, yes. Maybe we should run it background every night, maybe, and give us this result. Okay, perfect. No problem. Thank you.
Correct. This transaction we can run in background, and you can get this report also. Okay, the day wise and everything, you can get it. Okay, so but I will explain you with the practically after creating certain data. I can show you practically how it looks like. Okay, yeah. And okay, so these are the important fields in manufacturing. Okay, so I will stop the class now. Okay, when we will have the next class, can we have tomorrow or
tomorrow Saturday?
Yeah.
Yes,
Saturday, Sunday.
Yes, we can have. Okay, no issue.
No issue on Saturday. Okay. Yeah. So okay, tomorrow also we will have the class. Okay, same time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This Murali will send you the invitation, means confirmation to you. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.
You too. Bye-bye.